Welcome back for another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Today, I have Lior with me to learn all about the Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes Landing Zone Accelerator. After watching the episode, check out the links and the description in the show notes below. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Welcome back. My name is Thomas, and I'm here with Lior to talk about the Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes Landing Zone Accelerator. But first, before we talk about this, this is obviously all about hybrid and multi-cloud. So Lior, can you tell us a little bit why this is important?
For sure, Thomas. If you remember, back in January, we released the first accelerator. That was the accelerator for Azure Arc-enabled servers. Now, as we are getting more mature with the hybrid technologies that we are developing here in Microsoft, and obviously Azure Arc is in the middle of those Azure hybrid technologies, you know, we decided to, you know, take it one step further and develop this accelerator, which we're going to talk about today. To take a step back, why this is so important, you know, the hybrid and the multi-cloud motion is not going to stop. This is literally going to be the de facto standard for a lot of the organizations. And what we wanted to do is we wanted to accelerate, no pun intended, the way that we are delivering the suite of products or suite of features and capabilities when it comes to Azure Hybrid. That includes Azure Arc, it includes Azure Stack HCI, AKS on HCI, and all these technologies are coming together into one single motion, which is Azure Hybrid and multi-cloud. That's why it's so important. And again, this is going to be the standard for many organizations moving forward.
Oh, it's awesome. And again, it's a very important initiative, right, when it comes when we talk about hybrid and multi-cloud. So you quickly mentioned Azure Arc, and obviously we talked a lot before and we talk a lot about that. It's one of our main offerings when it comes to hybrid and multi-cloud. So for those people who don't know what Azure Arc is, can you quickly explain what it is?
Of course. Azure Arc is really a set or a suite of technologies that are designed to either bring IT assets and services and applications into Azure that are deployed outside of Azure by definition, or it's designed to deploy Azure services like SQL Managed Instance or PostgreSQL, app services, machine learning. The way that we are doing this is by stretching our control plane. And what does that really mean? A control plane is really Azure Resource Manager. That's the operating system of Azure. That's what we always like to say. And what we're doing with Azure Arc, we're bringing all the richness of Azure into the outside world and being able to either bring resources in or deploy resources using Azure Arc.
Okay, no, that's pretty awesome. Again, we obviously need that very much when it comes to hybrid, and that really enables our customers with this. So the Landing Zone Accelerators, they're part of the cloud adoption scenarios. And can you quickly tell us like what that is?
Right. Few months back, we decided that we now need to come together as a subject matter experts, groups of people here in Microsoft, and really invest the time on providing guidance on how should you actually approach hybrid architecture, right? How do you as a customer, as an organization, want to adopt architectures that are based on resources that are deployed or IT assets that are deployed in Azure, but also on premises and in other clouds? So what we wanted to do with the cloud adoption framework hybrid scenario, hybrid and multi-cloud scenario, is basically create this set of reference architectures, guidance, best practices, design considerations, recommendations, and also reference implementation in order for you to go and start using Azure hybrid multi-cloud in the right way, the way that we see it and gets our seal of approval. So that's really how everything started. And we actually released our new enhancement to that back in January with the Azure Arc-enabled servers Landing Zone Accelerator.
Oh, that's awesome. Again, the hybrid and multi-cloud scenario is super helpful for our customers when they are in a situation to implement this. And it has all these best practices and architectures, as you mentioned, all in one place. So obviously, I want to ask you, like, we have all this information now. How do we actually help customers to like implement all of that?
So we started with basically reference implementations to do this type of stuff. But before I'm talking about the reference implementation there, I wanted to talk to you about the critical design areas that we develop for Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes landings on accelerators. You know, when we developed servers and we released that back in January, we had 7 critical design areas for Azure Arc-enabled servers. This time, using Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, we actually developed 10 critical design areas because of the breadth of the technologies and the ecosystem of Kubernetes. And there's so much ground to cover, really, when you're thinking about Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, you're thinking about not just the infrastructure stack, but you also want to understand how a developer experience will look like. What are the services that are integrating into this type of technologies? So we just came up with 10 critical design areas that we are covering, as you can see in front of you. And those critical design areas, each and every one of those are covering really the best practices, covering the really the considerations and the things that you want to know before you go by and start designing this at scale. So these are the critical design areas for Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes. Now, in terms of the reference implementation, what we did, we actually created a new reference implementation for the accelerator. Again, back in January, when we released servers, we created a new flavor of ArcBox. ArcBox is part of the Jumpstart project, and it's basically a single unit of deployment that we developed in order for you to actually experience everything. Now, we took the same approach with Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, and as you can see with the architecture in front of you, we created ArcBox for DevOps, which we released this week. Now, what we're doing with DevOps, we basically created a reference implementation that is focusing on the Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes set of technologies and all the integrations that you see here. So this flavor is designed to bring you up to speed when it comes to the extensions, when it comes to the service discoverability, GitOps processes, secret managements, and things that you really need to take into account when it comes to this type of technologies. And obviously, this complement all the critical design areas for Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes that I just talked about before.
No, that's awesome. And again, I love that we bring all these critical design areas together and help our customers, especially now while Kubernetes is coming more and more important for a lot of organizations, right? And they're not just running Kubernetes in Azure, but they also run Kubernetes on-prem or at other cloud providers. And Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes really helps them to integrate that and bring that in a single control plane and also allow a couple of other scenarios like deploying, obviously, Azure PaaS services and Azure Data services in these locations as well.
Right.
So that is pretty awesome. Now, you covered that already a little bit, right? But what does the landing zone actually include? Can you talk a little bit about more details on that as well?
Sure. So the landing zone accelerator include 10 critical design areas. It also includes the reference implementation. And it also basically include all the jelloing pieces, like the things that you need to think about in terms of cross-referencing between those critical design areas, right? So for us, it's not enough for just developing those critical design areas. It's also important for us to make sure that when you are reading one critical design areas, we're making those mental connections for you. What are the things that you need to take under consideration with regards or with relationship to the other critical design areas? So this is super important for our viewers to understand, because for us, everything comes together as a single thing. It's not just about reading things in an isolation. It's really about to have an holistic, complete story around how do you go by an architect Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes landings on accelerator or a foundation in your organization. And the last piece, Thomas, that I really want to bring up is the fact that Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes is really a foundation, a building block, a fundamental building block for everything that will come after that, right? Azure Arc-enabled data services. You mentioned PaaS services, right? So Azure Arc-enabled data services, machine learning, app services, all those technologies are relying on the fact that you have an Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes-enabled cluster. So part of this accelerator is also to show you how are things going to look like in the future for you.
Well, again, this is fantastic, and it really excites me. Also, if you look at these different combinations with Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, but then also bringing in, for example, our Azure AKS on Azure Stack HCI or Windows Server, and having that full solution set. So really excited for everything which is also coming there. Now, so obviously, when we talk about hybrid and multi-cloud, sometimes things are hard to try out, right? Obviously, we love when people can try out and integrate it into their local environment, but often they don't have access to it or don't have the resources to spin up all these testing environments and stuff like that on premises or anywhere else. So do we offer something to people to try this out?
Right. So, yeah, I mean, ArcBox for DevOps is really our reference implementation. You can go check it out in the Jumpstart project webpage. And what we did with this edition is really try to give you everything with just you need to bring your own subscription. There are no constraints. You don't need to have a physical environment. You don't need to have an environment outside of Azure. All you need is a subscription so you can go and deploy that. And one of the things that we included as part of the enhancements that we worked on in the previous version and we took for this version as well, or this flavor, like we like to call it in the Jumpstart project, is basically all four methods of deployment. You have ARM templates, you have the portal experience, Terraform, and of course, Bicep is also another implementation that we support. So you can choose whatever it is that you feel comfortable. The result will be the same. You will get an ArcBox DevOps fully deployed environment. So you can go and check it out and actually get going with Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes. And while doing so, thinking about the critical design areas we develop for you.
Absolutely fantastic. So Lior, if people are now interested to learn more about this, where do they go?
So obviously we're going to share the link for the new accelerator. This is going to be part of the Cloud Adoption Framework web page and documentations. Also, go to the Jumpstart, start checking out the ArcBox for DevOps. Obviously, we're going to have links for you as part of the accelerator itself in Azure Docs. And these are the two resources that I can highly recommend.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Lior. And thank you, everyone watching. And don't forget to check out the Cloud Adoption Framework on aka.ms/adopt.